Hello everybody, my name is Dude, and welcome to Her Tears Are My Light. This is a new game by the developer of Syrup and the Ultimate Sweet, who seemed slightly embarrassed to talk about this game on Twitter. In fact, they said, and I quote, "I can't believe everyone's gonna read my gay writing, I'm so embarrassed I've only survived by not thinking about how embarrassing it is." We're gonna embarrass them a little bit. Her? Him? I don't know. Them. We're gonna embarrass them a little bit. And they're gonna tell me what gender they are in the comments, maybe. Whatever. I don't care. Let's go. Start. See how gay this writing is. Darkness. Darkness and nothing in all directions. At some point, I started thinking, shouldn't there be something here? Something? Anywhere? So I started looking. I don't know what exactly I was looking for, but as I wandered, I spotted a light in the distance. Ooh. Hello? As I approached, I found another, and another. A trail of burning bright lights. They traveled out and away, their steady glow piercing tiny holes in the darkness. They fascinated me. I decided I'd walk until I'd reached the source.
Ah, no! Don't cry, little girl! Don't cry, little Patchouli. I want to hug you.
And a girl, she was sitting on a bed of those stars. Aw, it was a beautiful sight.
Sight of a crying girl is not beautiful. You need to hug them. And then
they're happy and stuff. Sadness is not beautiful. I'm not sick, well,
I hope you know what I mean when I say that, but... someone's here.
What should I say to her?
Are you crying? Well, it's all I can say.
Excuse me, but have you been crying? I felt so lonely, I just can't seem to stop. Now someone's here. I don't think someone would come, but you're here.
I'm so happy.
If you're happy, then stop crying, honestly, Space. Oh. How did you know my name?
I don't know, Oh, we're time? We're the personification of time? And there's space? No! I'm a Time Lord! Or the personification of time, close enough! Damn it!
How did I know her name? She never told it to me, but something about her feels so familiar, like an old friend.
Well, we are the personification of time, maybe we did see her. Oh no! This isn't fair! I didn't even get to introduce myself, and now I have to ask for your name.
It's time.
Time. Time! Time, 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 time!
What are you doing? Saying it 8 times will help me remember. 8 is on its side. On its side is infinity, that's how I'll never forget.
Huh!
Okay, so time. Where'd you come from?
I don't know. The start?
I'm gonna say I don't know. I'm not sure. It's hard to describe a place with nothing in it. Were you alone in the dark too? Oh no.
Thinking of that makes me stop crying! You're crying. Hug the girl, time! God damn it!
I can't help it. When I think of how you must have felt, I just... The more she cried, the more stars came out. They were beautiful, but I couldn't help but think there weren't enough stars. Weren't there enough stars already? Couldn't quite place the reason why, but I definitely didn't like seeing her cry like this.
I don't either. Hug her, damn it!
Here, I'll try to describe it in a way that doesn't make you start crying. Huh? Place? Okay. If I had to give it a name, I'd call it the start. Start. Yes, that would make sense to start.
Oh, fuck! Right, heavy middle finger. God damn it.
Okay. Moving away from the right click. Does that mean where we are now in the middle? You started here, didn't you? I don't know if we can call it the middle.
We can't! This place has changed.
Has it?
Yes, you're here with me now.
You're here with me now, time. So before was the start, and now's the middle. Made sense in its own way. This girl is very straightforward. So if there's a beginning, is there an end? Who knows?
I don't know! I'm the personification of time! I decide when there's an end!
And you're space, so you also decide when there's an end, because... space is vast and probably infinite. Time, also probably vast and infinite, as long as there's space. So when it's together, as long as you don't decide, like, oh hey, there's an end, just whatever. There probably is one.
No! No, there isn't. You decide when the end comes, I decide when my end comes. That's it. That's all you need to know. I don't want that!
You cry a lot, don't you?
Yes, because look, whenever I do, these stars come out.
I already noticed, but maybe it'd be rude to point that out.
Can't really explain it, but somehow, they make me feel a little less lonely.
Oh!
Considering a star is a planet, or a sun, rather, you're basically making different suns and galaxies and solar systems and stuff, and holy shit. You're making you're making civilization. You've just been here making stars?
Yes.
See, where there is nothing, I want to put something. Does that make sense?
Yes.
What kind of things do you do, Ty? I move the universe. I make the universe move. Forwards, backwards, I can jump to any moment I've already experienced.
Wow,
that sounds like hard work.
Not really.
Making stars sounds harder to me.
Oh, that's easy. Watch.
Don't start crying again! I didn't mean to make you cry. Actually, this is a good chance to demonstrate.
Huh?
Alright, I've remembered the outcome. Now I'll rewind to when I said making stars sounds harder. I can try to stop her from crying. I need to rewind. I have a button for this. It's at the bottom of the Rewind. It's at the bottom of the screen. If I can make use of the rewind button, I'll end up going in circles. And if I get stuck, I can always reset. But for now, I need to rewind.
Shit!
Did I break the game? Rewind. I know I have a button for it, but I don't have any. Do I have to reset? Do I have to reset? Oh, I just keep heading backward. Okay. I just keep heading back. Oh, that's it. Hey, don't start crying just to prove how easy it is, okay?
Huh? How'd you know I was about to-
That's my power. You already cried before, so I went back to the moment before you did it in order to stop you. I thought I had to, like, press the button once and it would take me back there, not, like, keep clicking and clicking. Okay.
Wow, you're incredible, Time.
It was nothing, really. You know something? I only just met you, but it feels like we've always known each other.
Maybe because time and space is wibbly-wobbly.
I didn't know your name from the first moment I saw you, so maybe your feeling is true. But I can't remember talking with you like this before now. Just like I can't remember crying before you changed what happened. It must be a paradox.
Oh crap! No! No! We don't need that! We don't need paradoxes!
We don't need that. Hey, how'd you find me in the first place? I just followed your stars and here you were.
Oh, that means.
If we ever get separated, I can just cry. That way you'll always be able to find me.
Sure, but I don't know if I like the thought of making you cry again.
I won't have to, as long as you're here with me.
I'm kind of afraid to go back to being alone.
Alright, I'll stay.
It doesn't seem like there's anyone else out here anyway, so I have no reason to leave.
Anyone? Oh no.
There is someone out there, don't you think we should try looking for them?
Yes.
You don't want them to feel lonely, do you?
Foot? Dang it, there we go. Exactly. I'm so happy you understand, Time.
Friends! Yay!
We wandered into the void together to see if we could find anything else out there, but all we found was darkness. The more darkness we found, the more space would cry. I didn't like seeing her cry. I didn't want her to feel lonely. Much to my relief, she agreed to rest when I suggested it. I closed my eyes for a while. When I opened them again, I was back in the dark.
Space?
No response.
What happened?
Well, the stars are gone, too. Did I make a mistake? I'll rewind from here to before I close my eyes.
Oh, I gotta rewind now. Okay.
I won't close my eyes this time. I have to pay attention so I won't miss what caused everything to go black.
Time? You look so serious all of a sudden.
Something strange happened, but I don't know what it is.
Something strange?
Standing in the cosmos, I noticed something seemed to be blotting out a group of stars in the distance. I spotted the anomaly. I could just barely make it out against the dark background of the void. There was someone out there after all.
Is it the personification of black holes and rips in the space-time continuum? soon as they noticed I'd spot them, they disappeared. I squinted towards the area I'd been standing only a moment before, thinking I could easily find them again at such a distance. Very suddenly, oh, hello! She appeared right behind space. What are you?
Nil.
Nil. Whoa. She phased right through space, somehow erasing her from existence.
What? Excuse me? Rude! You little shit, get the fuck away from her! Bitch!
Stars around us dimmed and faded as she disappeared. This is what happened before. This is what I'd missed by taking my eyes off her. It was awful. I wanted it to stop. Where space stood once before me, there was now only nil.
What have you done to space and the stars? You took away all the beauty, now all that's left is the void!
But it's beautiful like this too, isn't it?
No. No, I don't like it! Bring back space! Bring back your stars!
If that's how you feel, I'll lock you in this moment until you understand.
No! I won't accept this, but what can I do?
If I return to the start, start over now, I could change this. Otherwise, I'll be trapped in this loop. Oh, I gotta restart. Oh, I guess I could just reset. Oh, I can't rewind anymore. Okay, yeah, I do have to reset.
Yes, abandon this timeline, do it again! I'll be right back!
Oh, that didn't take long. You're alive! I thought something terrible happened, but you're right here. I'm glad you're still okay, huh? She looked at me like she'd never seen me before. Because of course she hadn't seen me before. This space was new. How could I have expected her to remember what happened? In my excitement to see her alive and well, I'd forgotten that rule. Decided to recreating the first memory. Never mind. Excuse me, but have you been crying? I felt so lonely, but I can't seem to stop, and now someone's here. I didn't think someone would come, but you're here. How'd you know I'm in it? Of course I knew your name, even though you didn't tell it to me the first time either.
This isn't fair! I ain't gotta introduce myself, but that's time.
Time. What are you doing?
Saying it 8 times will help me. Fuck! God damn it! Okay.
So it's impossible for you to remember when I go back to before I told you. So, time. Where'd you come from?
The future!
But no, we'll say the start. If I had to give it a name, I'd call it the start. Yes, that seems correct. Does that make where we are now the middle? But you started here, didn't you? I don't know if we can call it the middle.
We can. This place has changed.
Has it?
Yes, you're here with me now. Time, so before I was the start, and now we're the middle.
2 starts, 2 middles, and 1 end so far. I was able to change the middle, which means... So if there's a beginning, is there an end?
I've already seen it.
We'll say who knows, because I don't know. What I saw before doesn't have to be the end.
I'll change it.
There probably is one.
No.
Unless Nell's a bitch.
Probably Nell's a bitch.
She'll probably... yeah. You cry a lot, don't you? Yes, because look, whenever I do, those stars come out. You told me before, even it was obvious from the start. I can't really explain it, but somehow they make me feel a little less lonely. So from the start, you've just been making all these stars? Yes, see... it's nothing. I want to put something. Does that make sense? Yeah, it's nicer that way.
I'm so happy you'd say that.
What kind of things do you do, Ty?
I move the universe. Forwards, backwards, and wibblety wobblety doobity doo. Wibblety dabblety doobity doo.
Jump at any moment I've already experienced. Wow, sounds like hard work. Yeah, it can be hard sometimes. But I can do good things with this power. It's like how your stars brighten up the cosmos, I can brighten the future. It's really cool.
You're so cool, Yabby.
You know something? I only just met you, but it feels like we've already always known you. Your feeling could be true. It'd at least explain how I knew your name. But I can't remember talking. That's the power. It seems like only I can remember those things. How'd you find me in the first place? That's easy. I already knew you'd be here waiting for me. But I'm talking about the very first meeting, before you knew where I was. What about then? I just followed your stars and here you were.
That means...
hey, if we ever get separated, I can just cry. That way you'll always be able to sure, but I don't know if I like the thought of making you cry.
I won't have to, as long as you're here with me.
I'm kind of afraid to go back to being, I know.
It's okay, space, come here.
Hugs. Hugs all around. Hug.
Glad you feel the same time. Might be alright to just lay here together just for a little while. If you want to, then I don't mind.
I held their hands so that Nil wouldn't be able to sneak up on us. My fingers interlaced so easily. It was as if they belonged together like this, but that was impossible. That feeling, even if it didn't make any sense, only made me hold tighter. As long as I held on to space, Nil wouldn't be able to take her away. We could lay here and admire the stars together, and never do anything else. I'd be satisfied just like this.
Can I ask you something?
Sure!
What is it? What happened before? What was it that you came back in order to change?
We got separated.
Oh no. Couldn't you follow my stars?
I couldn't. You weren't able to make them anymore.
That's terrible.
Yeah, it was.
Glad you came back. If we couldn't find each other, I'd want to change that too.
We lay there in silence for a while. I had the feeling space could sense, well, I was waiting for something. She didn't ask what. As long as I held on to her, she had nothing to worry about.
Nil, surely she was watching us from somewhere. The light, space's stars didn't reach.
I wanted to be ready. I wanted to be able to stop her when she appeared. But we fell asleep.
Oh no! Son of a shit!
Let it happen again. I've lost space again.
Time, don't go back anymore.
Why are you doing this?
She's just going to trap me here again, isn't she?
Say.
Stay.
Stay.
Why?
I can't go back any further than that.
Can I just punch you?
Yes, abandon this timeline. What can I do now?
Is there something else I can change?
Darkness. Darkness is the only thing I knew what I had to do. I had to start looking for space, and as I wandered, I spotted a familiar light in the distance.
Someone's here. What should I do?
Well, I can't just, like, keep going.
I wanted to say this, but I probably shouldn't, because that would ruin the timeline and some shit.
So, well, fine, I'll do it. So listen carefully. Someone called Nil's going to come and take you or all the beautiful stars away.
Huh?
Please trust me. My name is Time, and I came from a future where that's what always happens in the end. I understand. I know it's a lot to take in. I want to protect you. I don't want Nil to take you away.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Stop it!
No. You don't want to be all alone either, do you? If you feel the same as me, then it must have hurt. It's okay. I'm able to come back to prevent things like this. Please don't cry.
Okay.
I told Space about the other versions of our meeting that I knew of. I told her that Nil was somehow able to limit my power, trapping me in loops that keeping me from rewinding far enough to stop her whenever she appeared. And Space wanted to help. She said if we worked together, we might have a chance. It's better than trying to fight this monster on my own. Nil seems to only appear when we let our guard down. I tried waiting before, but we fell asleep. We have to make our first move.
What should we do?
I don't know. We could go back far enough, just enough to know exactly what's going to happen, so I'd be able to fix it. The only way I've been able to learn anything is through seeing you get taken away. I don't want to watch that happen again.
Time?
You're working hard, aren't you? I want to help.
Hugs! Yay! Hugs! Just what I was hoping for! Yay! Yay! No stats! Hugs! Only hugs! Only ever hugs!
I don't want you to feel alone. I'm still here, so I hope I can do something for you. We stayed like this for a while. She was warm. It felt nice. Started pausing the universe here in this moment.
I'm gonna save here, if I can.
How do I save? Here we go. Saving there. There we go. After all, moving forward could cause something awful to happen again. And it was up to me whether or not to let this path play out. But I knew I didn't have to be afraid because I wasn't alone.
God damn it!
Nilladart, you seem a little more pissed.
Just a little bit.
Why are you doing this?
This is Nil. Why do you look like me?
You're the copy. Why don't you just stay erased?
Space, run! I'll stop her!
But I don't want to be separated from... It's only temporary! I promise I'll be back to find you later, so get out of here!
I don't like this. I don't like this!
Whoa.
Well, in an instant, Nil's body blinked out of existence. She'd slipped through my grasp. Once again, space was gone. Is there anything I could do? Nil had beaten me no matter what I tried. My attempts to change fate were only hurting space again and again. Time.
What? Why won't you look at me? Keep taking space away. Of course I wouldn't want to look at someone who'd do that.
You're crying for her? Felt so overwhelmed by hopelessness, I barely noticed my tears. How strange, I thought. Me to cry so easily. Space was always the one who... There it was again. Feeling I'd known her for so much, for much longer than I possibly could have. I didn't understand these feelings. Aren't you going to reset again? What's the point if you'll always... Again? She said again. And she remembers the other timelines that I... Asked you before, what are you? I am Nil. Emptiness. Void. Whatever you want to call me. Whenever there is something, I want to make it nothing. Does that make sense?
Why would you want to do that?
It exists just to take space away? Space exists to take me away. Why can't you understand? Must I explain it to you? Time, please listen. I'll save here. Fine, why not? You're still here. You'll really listen? Sure, just say what you want to say, damn it. Fine. If I know why she's doing all this, I'll be able to think of a way to stop her, but there's another feeling in my heart when I look at her.
Sympathy? Why?
Probably because she looks like space. In the very, very beginning, I was alone. There was only me in the thick, empty, infinite darkness that surrounds us now. At some point, I thought I wanted there to be more than just that. That's when I changed from nothing to something. It was also when you first appeared, Time. From that point on, it felt like we were all that there ever was, and all there ever would be. One time and one space, and know what? It's so much fun together, I thought it would last for all eternity. But then my light faded, and you stopped. You stopped, but I was still there.
Oh!
I was still there, but you rewound to be with the light I'd left behind.
Oh! Oh, you are space!
I waited for the end to come again, thinking maybe I could reach you there. Whenever it came, you would just rewind again, to be with another new me. Another new space. It made me so jealous. I waited for so long for you to find me. But how could you? I couldn't cry. I couldn't create any light of my own for you to follow. You found new lights. Her stars. You forgot about me.
How could that be true? I don't have any memories like that. There's no way I could forget about space.
But you did, again and again. She always returns to nothing, to me. And you always go back to the beginning. You never stay with me. You always want to stay with space, but not Nil. It's because my darkness isn't as beautiful. You'll always choose her stars over me. I erased everything, all the universes, and started over with just one. Just one for you and me. But space is always there, too. You always go to her.
Is that why I can't remember?
So you erase the universe that held those memories? You know what all the universes are now? It's you and space together, and I'm alone. That's why. So I wanted to bring you to the end faster. I even learned how to stop you from rewinding. When I erased her, I could finally reach you, but you only got mad at me. You finally set everything right, but you didn't understand anything at all. I was stupidly hoping you would remember everything if you could just see me again. I was so angry when you didn't. I don't recall our memories that were erased, unless these feelings in my heart. Still can't stop you from resetting. Can't stop you from doing what always brought you closer to her. You've been going farther and farther away. I didn't know what to do anymore. I didn't want to have to explain it all to you like this. I wanted you to remember on your own, but I can't take this anymore. Nil. Even if those memories were erased from me, they still left an impression in my heart. That impression, that love has driven my every action up to this point. But you and space are connected. All my memories with you were with who space is now. That's how I got it confused.
I don't want to hear that.
Thanks to you, I finally understand what I've been feeling all along. It's that you are someone who's very precious to me. Even if those feelings were projected onto a you who wasn't you anymore. I'm sorry, Nil. So mean. Treated me like the bad one.
I didn't remember! Fucking hell, what do you want from me? Every fuck universe. Wibbly wobbly. Timey wimey. What do you want?
I was the one who messed up from the start. Can you ever forgive me? All I wanted was to be at your side again, and you forgot about me. I won't forgive you so easily. It's fine. I'll work hard to make it up to you.
Good. We have all of eternity to do that. Just the two of us.
Just the two of us, huh?
It's fine.
Yeah, it is fine.
So happy. I waited for this for so long.
I know. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Bill and I spent all of eternity together, just like she said.
Alone together in the darkness, without space's light. Felt like I'd left something behind, but being together with Nil... No, with my true space. That was all that mattered. I had a lot to make up for.
Well, I hope that was a good ending. The music makes it sound kinda bad, but this seems like it's the better of the endings that I could've gone for, because they always end in stuff. Unless I could've gone... Could have merged Nil with space, and then space would have won, and then happy ending all around. But I guess space does kind of fade out eventually.
Hey, this is a neat little game. I got a lot to cut up. Oh well.
Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. This is neat. It wasn't as it was pretty cheesy.
Nom nom, Nami. I'll call you Nami.
That was kind of cheesy, but not too bad. That was good. Anyway, thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Leave a like if you did. Subscribe for more. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And thank you to TKR and Tro for supporting me on Patreon this month. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye!
Oh, God, no. Oh, God, no. 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 No, we're not going there.
Well, I got a thing for what, guys, sir. And it's not a helper thing. It's a big piece of lead. What?